Hi guys! Welcome to part 2 of learning how to do web testing and website interaction using Selenium and Python. Let's go ahead and get started.
In the previous video, we learned about what web testing is. We also identified and compared the two types of web testing, which is manual and automated web testing. In that video, we also learned what test cases are and how to create them. So now, we are ready to install the tools and dependencies needed for web testing. The first tool we need to install is Python. Python is the scripting language that we will be using to create our automation scripts. Next is Visual Studio Code. This will serve as our IDE, or our Integrated Development Environment, which we will be using to write our code into. Next is Selenium, or our testing tool for this automation web testing. We will be particularly using the Selenium WebDriver to do this job. Lastly, we will be installing a browser extension called Selectors Hub, which will be our selector tool to locate our HTML elements in the web pages that we will be testing. So the first thing that we will be installing is the Visual Studio Code, or our IDE. I will put all the links for the downloads in the description below, so you can go ahead and click those. If you are using a Windows machine, click here to download for Windows. If you are using another OS besides Windows, click on the download right here. Select the appropriate installer for your machine, but as for me, I am using Windows, so I'm gonna click Windows. A download should start as soon as you click the button. Next is we're gonna install Python. To install Python, go to this website, hover over to the downloads, and click the latest version for your OS. A download should also start right away after clicking this button. Let's go ahead and set up our Visual Studio Code. Double-click the setup to launch the installer. Click on Accept and browse where you want to install the Visual Studio Code. After the setup is done, we can opt to choose to launch Visual Studio Code. Clean installation of Visual Studio Code should look a little something like this. Great, now we have Visual Studio Code, or our IDE, installed on our machines. The next thing that we need to install is the Python. We go ahead and run this with administrator privileges. Let's go ahead and click install now. But make sure to click on the Add Python Exe to the Path. After that, we can click on Disable Path Length Limit and close this setup. Let's go ahead and go back to our Visual Studio Code. In the Visual Studio Code, can navigate to a folder where we want to create our project. Just click on I Trust the Authors. Now we can click on this button right here to activate the terminal. If you are using a Windows machine, it should open a PowerShell terminal. But if you're using a Mac OS, you should see something like Z shell written instead of PowerShell. Let's go ahead and run this command, Python --version. This will verify that our Python installation has been successful. If there are problems occurring, if you installed Python while the VS Code is still running, make sure to restart the VS Code and try this command, python --version again, and it should display the latest version that is installed in your machine. Now we have 2 out of 4 of the tools that we need installed. By the way, if you are using a Mac OS, you should use a command which is python 3--version instead of Python only. Now, after verifying that those two are installed, we can now clear on everything that is inside our folder, which are the installers. The next thing that we need to do is to create a virtual environment. Let's type in python --m vend for a virtual environment, and let's name our virtual environment myenv or my environment. For Mac users, type on python 3--m vend myenv. This should create a new directory called myenv. To activate our virtual environment, let's go ahead and type in the path and type in activate. If you run into an error like this about execution policies, go ahead and type in this command and go ahead and try to reactivate our virtual environment. Great. Now we have created our virtual environment. Great. Now we have activated our virtual environment. Inside our virtual environment, we can now install our dependencies without affecting the directories inside our system. Let's go ahead and type in pip install selenium for us to install selenium on our virtual environment. The same command can be used to install selenium in Mac OS. If you get this prompt, it means you have successfully installed Selenium in your virtual environment. To double check or to verify the installation of Selenium, type in pip list. You should see the version of Selenium in here if you have successfully installed Selenium. Now, let's go back to our browser and download the Chrome driver. Go to this website and click on this hyperlink right here that says the Chrome for Testing Availability Dashboard. Click on it and click on this table. Let's find the Chrome driver that is fit for our system's architecture. Let's go ahead and copy this link and enter it to an empty tab. This should download a zip folder. Go ahead and extract this zip folder. Inside the extracted folder, you should see a .exe file or an application file. Go ahead and cut that out. Paste it back to your root folder. After doing so, then go ahead and delete the installer. Now you have successfully downloaded the Chrome driver. The last thing that we need to install is Selectors Hub. Selectors Hub is an extension on Chromium browsers, and we can download it using this link right here. Click this to install it. Click Add to Chrome. And Add to Chrome. Add this extension. And those are all the installations you need to get started with Selenium in Python. In the next video, we will be performing some testing and some web interaction using Selenium in Python. If you found this video helpful, please make sure to leave a like and subscribe to the OneCodeCamp channel.